Hi, my name is David, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a black mask for printing with ghost white toner onto dark fabrics. So you might have seen multiple videos where I use the ghost white toner cartridges inside different HP Laserjet printers to transfer a multicolor or single color design to dark cotton textiles, to dark bags, dark t-shirts, and other dark materials. The shirt that I actually wear with Tony the Tiger is one of those designs where you actually need to have a white underprint to get the design correctly transferred from your transfer paper to the dark fabric. So the colors of Tony are some orange, some red, some blue, and a lot of blacks here in his stripes, in his tiger stripes. And to have these blacks, we need to run a four-color print using the cyan, magenta, yellow, and black toner cartridge. Then we have to reinsert the paper and run a white layer in behind it to have the whites in place and to also cover the colors with a white underprint for better transfer. If you have a picture like Tony's or other design on your computer, what you need to do is you need to create a mask and completely fill it with black to have this second file for their underprint. We got the feedback from many users that, you know, they hustle to do this in Photoshop, so we decided to make a quick tutorial video where I'm actually going to take the Tony image, make a black mask around it, shrink the mask a little bit so that I don't have white highlights coming out on the left or the right in the underprint, so that it aligns correctly in the double printing, two-pass printing. And then I'm going to save it as two files, one color Tony file and one black Tony file. And in a future video, I will actually print this file and transfer it and do the t-shirt that I'm actually wearing today. You can check out the video in the link up here. And I'm going to turn to the computer now and start creating that mask. So this is the Tony file on the screen here. I have just downloaded it. The file name is called Latest. And what I'm going to do is that I'm actually going to save it as a PDF file. So I go to File, Save As. I choose Photoshop PDF and I save it. All right, I just use the Acrobat standard settings, high quality PDF. All right, so the next is I'm going to create a second file. Click File, Save As. And I'm going to call this file latest-mask. And this is actually my mask file. So I end up having Tony's color file secured and having a second file where I'm actually going to create a mask. To do this, I can do use different tools. I'm going to use the magic wand tool here. And I'm going to simply click into the white background of Tony. And I'm also going to add this little part here in the middle. With the shift key and clicking on it, so this will be added to my selection. I'm going to select inverse to invert my selection so that I only have selected the white areas, which I'm going to delete now. But before I do this, I'm going to zoom in a little bit. You can see Tony is perfectly selected, and what we're going to do now is we're going to shrink that selection a little bit to make sure that we have Tony. So we go to Select again, and we go to Modify, and we go to Contract. So we're contracting the selection. This time we're using 3 pixels. In other cases, you might want to use 4 or 5, but 3 should be totally fine here. This will make sure that the actual white layer is a little bit smaller than the color layer, so that it aligns better in the double pass printing, which has the advantage that there are no highlights coming out on the sides. You can see that perfectly here. The selection is a little bit smaller than Tony's fists. So I'm zooming out, and now I'm ready to delete the background. I'm creating a new layer before I do that, making this layer invisible, and I have the selection now. I use the fill tool and the black color, and I fill my whole selection with black. And now I have this all selected. I'm going to deselect. Now I'm going to merge the layers, say flatten the image. I discard all hidden layers. And now I only have a tony black layer, which I'm going to save now so that I have this second file on which I'm going to print. I now have two files. I have one color file, which we saved first, and I have the black mask file, which we saved last. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to, you know, just print these two files directly as PDF files and run you through the transfer process. This will happen in another video. I hope you find this video helpful, and it's now easier for you guys to make your mask for your images, for your vectors, or for your designs. Depending on how detailed your actual design is, you might, you know, need a little more Photoshop help. You might use the magic wand tool a little bit more to select all the areas that you don't want to have into your first selection, and then just simply fill the selection with black color for the underprinting. If you find the video helpful, please give us a thumbs up below. If you've got further questions, just drop us some comments under the video so that we can follow this up. If you want to see more videos like this, please follow the channel to stay up to date. I say thanks for watching and see you next time.